Hikmet Bamani. I'm one of the Kurdish activists in the United States. Today, we are as a Kurd. We've been through a lot of tragedies. And what happened here 2 or 3 weeks ago, we felt very sad and was unfortunate. And we condemn it in the hardest way. And we would like to be part to support the victim of this tragic incident that happened here. And we decided as a Kurdish community in Washington metropolitan area to do something at least we could do. As people, and many people are interested in, to donate some money to the victim of the incident, and that's what we're here for. For me as a Kurd, we've been through a lot of this. I'm sure same as Jew, through history. And after the 20th century, the Kurd has been used chemical weapon against them. They destroyed their villages. They've been thrown out of their home. They've been attacked by many times. The latest was Daesh and ISIS, what happened in Shingar and around the Kurdistan. And we feel like we are victim, and we're all together to fight the tyranny, the dark people who hate each other. We have to live together. I will give one example as a Kurd. In Kurdistan, we used to live together, Jew, Christian, Muslim, all together. One example, Zahu city, there was a three neighborhood. They called one Mahalla Fala, Mahalla Jio, Mahalla Bussalmana. There were the three neighborhoods, one for the Christian, one for the Jew, one for the Muslim. They're living side by side. And if you look at the history of the Kurdistan, in the village of Kurdistan, majority in Kurdistan villages, there were some Jews there living side by side. They've been, unfortunately, what not happened in another part of Iraq, that Jew and Christian, they live in the cities. But in the village, they can't get along together. But in Kurdistan was open to everybody. Even now, in Duhok, in Hawler, in Suleimania, they live side by side. They have a tolerance, respecting each other, respecting other human beings, respecting their religion, their belief. And that's what we're here for. We feel it doesn't matter who they are. And what we did here, we did for other things. We did it for Shingaris and Yazidis in Kurdistan. We did for Afrin. We did for Kermanshah. Whatever we can. As unfortunately, we are a very small community. We're not rich community, but we're doing our part just to be sure we are here to support them and be there for them, because we feel hurt what happened here. If you see what happened in Iraq, for example, when the old Christian ran away from Baghdad, from Basra, from where they came to Kurdistan. When Yazidi ran away, they all came to Kurdistan. When the things happened in Syria, they came to Kurdistan. As I said, same as Kurdistan, regional government of Kurdistan, they don't have that much revenue. They are not rich. They are one third of the people of the Kurdistan were the refugees, Arabs, Sunni, Shia, Christian, Yazidis, everybody. And even now, we're proud of that. And I'm very happy to say that. And all this incident after the collapse of Saddam Hussein, that's not one Christian has been killed by Kurds. Kurdish people. Not one religion being killed by the Kurdish people. There's only that we Mosque of Kurdistan, they emptied for the Yazidis. As other side, they call them, they are devil worshiper. But for us, they are human beings before anything else.